Hi guys, I'm Oris here. Today we are checking out this external SSD from Kingston XS1000 1TB. Now let's do a quick test of this Dell 7290 laptop, which has USB 3.1 interface. We are getting close to 500 megabytes per second. This means that we are using USB 3.1 Gen 1, which is basically the same thing as USB 3.0. Now, how about running Windows 98 from this drive? Can we do it? Yes, it's doable, but we cannot use a USB controller that is recognized by Windows 98, like this VIA 6212 we used earlier to test the USB 2 compatibility. Initially, BIOS will present our external SSD as a regular drive to Windows 98, but when the USB controller gets initialized, this emulation will break, and we end up with this I/O error screen. Now let's use the same drive but on a USB 3 port and see what happens. Well, this time there were no errors, so Windows 98 booted just fine from our external SSD. What happened? Well, now the external SSD is seen as a regular drive connected to some unknown controller. In this situation, the drive can be handled by Windows 98 using BIOS basic commands. Microsoft calls this MS-DOS compatibility mode. All Windows NT versions from NT 3.1 to the latest Windows 11 won't use this mode, and as soon as the disk drive cannot be initialized the way Windows NT wants, we'll end up with a blue screen and we cannot continue unless we deliver proper drivers for our disk controller. There are many reasons why Windows NT won't let BIOS to handle disk drives. And one of them is the overall degradation of system performance. Every time Windows wants to access the drive, has to switch the CPU to the real mode, which will slow down our computer. When using a modern computer with a fast CPU and lots of RAM plus some SATA SSD, this slowing down is not usually noticeable. But when we are using a USB drive instead of an SSD, things change because we are inviting to the party a slow USB controller inside our USB drive. A fast external SSD like this Kingston XS1000, since it can handle 1000 megabytes per second, has of course a very fast controller inside. The problem is that it has to use the USB protocol, which will cause some additional slowdown. Just let me show you. Here, Windows 98 is running directly from this Kingston external SSD. So far, so good. On the very same SSD, we have Quake 2. Let's run it and see what happens. Well, if we run Quake 2 directly from a USB drive, we get very distorted sound. This is a modern computer, and you may think that there are many reasons for this behavior, like some incompatibility of this Creative 64 PCI sound card with the PCI Express to PCI Bridge, maybe the CPU itself, and so on. But now let me start the same copy of the game from Drive D, which is a regular SanDisk SSD connected to a SATA port. Well, this is much better, even if our SSD is still using the MS-DOS compatibility mode. For a full Windows 98 experience, you should use a SATA drive plus the AHCI drivers made by Rudolf Lowe. You can go also the official way by using a SATA adapter. There are even PCI Express adapters with Windows 98 drivers. In the end, if we still want to install Windows 98 on a USB drive, the procedure is the same as for a regular drive. We just treat the USB drive as any other drive. That means that we need a FAT or FAT32 active partition that needs to be made bootable with MS-DOS. If we plan to install Windows 98 on anything newer than Intel 9th Gen CPU or a Ryzen 3000 series, we need to add to the mix CrackFix, a tiny patch that solves the vCache error. I'll leave here two links where you can find more about the vCache error and CrackFix, also a more detailed video on how to install Windows 98 on modern hardware. Thanks for watching. Maybe consider to hit that subscribe button. Thank you.